Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, Fight Fans. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. Tyson furious, clout chasing, and hating on Andy Ruiz Jr. And let's just start it out by digging into Tyson Fury's most recent statement, saying that Andy Ruiz Jr. is no better than a Derek Chisora. And I'm going to say that Derek Chisora is a quality fighter. He's a dangerous fight for any fighter. So you can't look at Derek Chisora as an easy fight by any means. But at the same time, he's not an elite level fighter. He's never been a unified world champion, similarly to Andy Ruiz. He's been beat 9 times and he's been knocked out 3 times. So to compare him to an Andy Ruiz Jr. is just unfair. And you could tell that Tyson Fury says that from a malicious standpoint, because Tyson Fury has beat Derek Chisora twice. And then you see Tyson Fury goes on to hate and clout chase Andy Ruiz Jr. even more by stating that he would beat the little fat pig Andy Ruiz Jr. easily. Now, let's be honest. Why would he call Andy Ruiz Jr. a little fat pig? Try to say these things about Andy Ruiz. And it's just clout chasing. He's saying these things to make headlines. And the reason why he said that to make a headline is he's trying to build up a fight between him and Deontay Wilder, because neither one of these guys have the U.S. star power that they would need to sell 1 million pay-per-views. These guys simply just don't have that power. These guys did less than 400,000 buys in what was pegged as supposed to be this big super fight. And so, these guys are trying to build up the rematch even bigger, and they're using Andy Ruiz and Anthony Joshua's names as leverage and clout for that fight. And you see that these guys really don't want to fight the best, because if they did, you see Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder both had the opportunity to fight Anthony Joshua. They passed. Andy Ruiz Jr. was the one who stepped up to that fight. And then you see Tyson Fury even come out and state that he would only need one hand to beat an Andy Ruiz Jr. And yes, Tyson Fury has height, reach over Andy Ruiz Jr., so he would present a problem for Andy Ruiz because of those intangibles. But the one thing that Tyson Fury doesn't have is elite level power. And since he doesn't have elite level power, for a guy like Andy Ruiz Jr., his style, which is being an aggressive pressure fighter with elite level hand speed, he would cause a major problem for Tyson Fury if he was able to close the gap and get on the inside with Fury. And most people will say, well, Fury's height and reach would keep Andy Ruiz out. The problem with that is we've seen a guy who's much more inexperienced, never fought at the level of Andy Ruiz Jr., doesn't have the hand speed or the power of Andy Ruiz Jr. in the Otto Wallin, close the gap and the distance on Tyson Fury, bust his face open, and pretty much take the fight to him for the majority of the rounds. So you see that Andy Ruiz Jr. would be able to close that gap rather easily if Otto Wallin would be, because you see that Andy Ruiz Jr. is just more sharp than Otto Wallin. See, Tyson Fury is not used to dealing with a guy like Andy Ruiz with that type of pressure and with that type of hand speed. And he also has some pop to go with it. So all of those things, because you have to be honest, Andy Ruiz Jr. has a lot more pop than Otto Wallin. And if Otto Wallin had enough power, he could have seriously hurt Tyson Fury and maybe even got him out of there. And there was moments in that fight where Fury looked badly hurt. So we have to be honest and unbiased. Tyson Fury is no monster of the division. His performance against an inexperienced C-level Otto Wallin has to be accounted for. And we have to understand styles truly do make fight. And you know what? They're tailor-made for each other. I think that'll be a very difficult fight for Tyson Fury as well as Andy Ruiz Jr. But it's obviously he's simply clout chasing his name. But once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP.